Well, I want to start a YouTube channel. I said to myself, why not? And I paint anyways. It's not going to cost me any extra money or extra time since I paint. So why not record, right? Just recently I found out that, hey, you get a lot of people watching you. YouTube will actually pay you. And apparently they figure if 10,000 people are watching you, it's worthwhile for them to advertise on your page. Then when that happens, you start getting paid. So life is short. I figure why not, you know. I'll give this a try. I hope you enjoy it. This is my new painting that I just started. So since I have insomnia and everything, I think it'd be nice for people that have insomnia also to you know, tune me on and see what I'm painting. And I like to paint, and while I paint I like to dance anyway, so I think I'll be entertaining. And you know, I'll make some commentary and stuff, and we'll see where this goes. So I hope you enjoy this, and thank you very much. So I'm here in Kapaha, pretty much my studio. Basically living the dream. And enjoy this fantastic view of the ocean. Since I have my eyes open, I realize, hey, I have this great situation where I'm living in this fantastic place. So why not live life to the fullest? So, and for me, which is painting. For me, painting is just time to reconnect with the whole primal urges that we human have. And if you don't know what I'm talking about being able to create, using your creative ideals, and being almost like the ultimate creator. I really believe when you create, let it be art and painting or music or acting or special talent, it's almost like your duty, I think. to express and do what you're supposed to do, because I think that's our purpose in life as an artist, is to create and somehow influence other people to appreciate the beautiness of life. And it's almost like a duty. If you don't do it, you're sinning. So I was thinking maybe for a username, what do you think, Freedom Boo Jackart? You know, art's been such a big part of my life. I did all kinds of art growing up, I guess. Something I had a natural talent for. And even in elementary, I remember being kicked out from our elementary school to do a mural for our cafeteria, because it was in the basement. And all we had was a view of an air condition and the wall behind it. So we did, if I'm not mistaken, a mural of the ocean. And it might have been the first time I was in the papers that is related to my art. So, yeah, then later on I did murals and my family had a restaurant, and I did some murals for the restaurant. Then later on, I was very fortunate, bless my mom, very supportive of my art, and she let me hang up my artwork the whole time she had the restaurant Garlic Tree at the Pike Place Market. Awesome time, early 90s in Seattle during the grunge time, and I was very fortunate. I was able to sell 100, if not more, artwork during that 14 years we had a restaurant at the Pike Place Market on Stewart Street, Garlic Tree. Found out later on I could sell a lot at hair salons, because, you know, it's hard to sell artwork in coffee shops because everybody's broke. But in hair salons, the ladies have money, right? That's why they get their hair done every month, and give them time to look at my art and go, wow, I really want this art. And convince her husband to buy it for her. And no, I'm just kidding. But anyway, I did sell a lot of artwork through hair salons, through the restaurant, cafeterias. I'm very lucky if I've had a lot of supporters in my life to buy my art and support me and give me the encouragement that I need to move on and keep doing what I'm doing. So, this one that I just started, let me show you the one that I've just been working on pretty much for the last 4 or 5 days. I like it, it's pretty nice, so I'm gonna show it off. So, I don't know if you guys can see that, but the light's actually behind the canvas, so might not be the best lighting for it, but yeah. Used to be all red, but now looked at it and tried to understand it and looked at it some more, because that's what you do when you start a piece. It's kind of like my style. It's kind of like what Michelangelo did with all his marble carvings. He sat down and looked at the piece of rock and said, okay, what do I see? And pretty much that's been kind of like, what I do. I'll start with some simple lines, simple shapes and colors, and then I'll let the universe tell me what I should do next, just by keeping my eyes open and appreciating what's in front of me, and not worrying about so much about the past. But we all know that's history, right? Gone. It's out of here. We don't have to deal with that anymore. And future, right? Future is tough because we don't know what's going to go on. So it's a big mystery. And so pretty much, whatever's gonna happen, it's gonna happen. So you could give some positive energy towards it, but pretty much it's all about appreciating what's in front of you now. The natural beauty of things, your friends, your family, music, the rose in front of you. And I've been doing that a lot lately, and it's almost like it's opened up a lot of doors for me. I'm almost breathing better and thinking better and just feeling better, just because I feel more connected. Well, anyway, blah 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 blah. I'm gonna go back to painting. I don't know how long I could record this thing. I don't want to make it too long, so Hope you guys are having a good day. Check me out. I'm starting this whole YouTube channel thing. I don't know everything about it. I've done some research, so bear with me. If any of my friends could help me out, I'm open ears. As far as I know, I don't know a damn thing. Not a damn thing. I'm open ears. I'm always willing to learn more. So, let me know. Ciao for now.